Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, good evening and a warm welcome to House Group Pentecost Celebration Special Service. Let us begin this special Pentecost Celebration Service in the name of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us invoke God's blessings. I request Ms. Leela Manase to invoke God's blessings.
We are grateful to you, O God, the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, for this privilege to invoke your presence in our midst. Amen. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and we know that it's the Spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on each face, and we know that Spirit of the Lord, sweet Holy Spirit, sweet heavenly dove, stay right here with us, filling us with your love. And for these blessings, we lift our hearts in praise. Without a doubt, we know that we have been here to seek your holy blessings. Into your presence we've come, not by the works we have done, but by your grace and your grace, O Lord. Into your presence we've come. Holy Spirit, we surrender ourselves to you. Minister to us through every aspect of this evening's worship. Amen.
Praise be to God. Now the house group conveners of all our house groups would present a special number.
Good evening all. The song that we are going to sing is a well-known Tamil Kirtanai that praises and speaks about the Holy Spirit. It expresses the people longing to find eternal happiness and peace through the grace of the Holy Spirit. The song emphasizes the importance of qualities like purity, contentment, compassion, and faith in overcoming obstacles and achieving the spiritual enlightenment. It also highlights the transformation power of the Holy Spirit in dispelling darkness and guiding the people towards liberation from early suffering.
Yeah.
Sincere thanks to all the house group conveners for that wonderful presentation. Let us commune with God responsively. Let us follow the responsive prayers. O God of mystery, your response. You call us to freedom. May we so participate that our lives may resonate with you. God's love has been poured into our hearts as we rejoice in the gift of this day. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful. Let us pray with one heart and mind. Amen. Let us all rise to our feet and sing to the glory of God. Hymn number 236. 236, the church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. Please be seated. Let us enter into the act of confession. Let us spend a few moments in silence in the presence of God. Let us recollect our minds, the sins that we have committed against God, against our fellow beings, against the creation of God, against ourselves. Let us ask God to forgive our sins. Let us repent of our sins. Let us reconcile with God, with those with whom we have committed sin, and let us reconcile ourselves. Let us ask God to forgive us and grant to us a new beginning. May his tongues of flame burn out all evil from our hearts. Fill us with his love and peace, and give us the gifts of the Holy Spirit, a voice to praise him and a life to serve him. Amen. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the perfect offering for our sins, and not us only, but also for the sins of the whole world. May the Almighty and Merciful God grant us pardon and remission for all our sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite Mrs. Anjana Samuel, the convener of the House Group Committee, to kindly come forward and address us.
Thank you, Aya. O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile. O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile. Heal and reconcile. Pentecost Sunday. The proper name, as we all know, we have heard today, is Whit Sunday, which means the 50th day after the Passover or Easter. It is the commemoration of the giving of the law on Mount Sinai. Christian Pentecost celebrates the giving of the new law written by the Spirit on the heart. At Sinai, Israel was constituted as a people of God in the upper room in Jerusalem. The Christian church was born. He shall teach you all things, John 14:26. The believer who accepts it becomes the faithful. Instructed by the Holy Spirit, we have the right judgment in all things. One comes to know the perfect will of God. The psalmist says, I delight to do the will of God. Yes, thy law is within my heart. We rejoice in his holy comfort. The Holy Spirit also strengthens us to do God's will, not only consolation, but fortification. The church, with its diversity, has gathered today to express her unity in Christ by the Holy Spirit and to manifest God's power among the people and nations. As a house group community today, celebrating Pentecost Sunday, it is this manifestation of the Holy Spirit that we invoke upon all of us this evening. As we meditate and listen also, along with the presentations and different choreographies that we're going to see today, let us also listen to the readings of the books of Acts chapter 14, verses 1 to 21, and also the 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verses 1 to 25. We relive the Pentecost story as told in the Bible. May we have a blessed evening ahead, and we look forward to all the participating house groups. At this time, I really would like to thank all the 14 house groups that are taking part, all its conveners and all its members, and also to all our clergy. Thank you. I now invite the Jayanagar, BTM and JP Nagar house group to give us their first presentation. The conveners are Mr. Ruben Singh and Mr. Robinson Doss. Over to the Jayanagar, JP Nagar, BTM house group.
Before we proceed with the first presentation by Jayanagar house group, let's hear the God's word as it is written in Acts, the book of Acts, chapter 14, verses 1 to 4. Acts, chapter 14, verses 1 to 4. Paul and Barnabas at Iconium. Now at Iconium, they entered together into the Jewish synagogue and spoke in such a way that a great number of both Jews and Greeks believed. But the unbelieving Jews stirred up the Gentiles and poisoned their minds against the brothers. So they remained for a long time, speaking boldly for the Lord, who bore witness to the word of his grace, granting signs and wonders to be done by their hands. But the people of the city were divided. Some sided with the Jews and some with apostles. Here ends the reading.
Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
So big thank you to the Jainagar, JP Nagar, BTM House Group. Can we give them another round of applause? Thank you. Thank you. So I know it's raining outside, heavy rain. And as we continue, I just would like to make an announcement that the refreshments are ready. So once the rain stops, those who are in a hurry, we would encourage that all of us can stay and encourage each other. But if you are still in a hurry, you can show your coupon and collect your refreshment. So each house group convener has already collected their coupons. If you haven't, then you could collect it from the organizing team there in the parish hall. Thank you. So I now call upon the next house group, which is the Kothanur House Group. And the Kothanur House Group is led by its convener, Mr. Paul Amitraj. So over to the Kothanur House Group.
Good evening to all, and let's hear the word of God taken from the book of Acts, chapter 14, verses 5 to 8. Acts chapter 14, beginning to read from verse 5. When an attempt was made by both Gentiles and Jews with their rulers to mistreat them and to stone them, they learned of it and fled to Lystra and Derbe, cities of Lycaonia, and to the surrounding country. And there they continued to preach the gospel. Now at Lystra there was a man sitting who could not use his feet. He was crippled from birth and had never walked. Here ends the word of God.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, reverends, and good evening, beloved members of the congregation. This evening, as we celebrate the momentous descent of the Holy Spirit on the apostles, we, the member of the Kothanur House Group, will usher in this special service with a very renowned song, a very well-known song by an American songwriter, singer, pastor, Don Mion. In fact, this was his backstage prayer. This was his plea to the Holy Spirit to reign over the prayers that he was going to present to the audience. So this evening, we, the Kothanur House Group, invite the presence of Holy Spirit as we sing this song, "This Is Your House" by Don Mion.
Thank you. Jesus says in Matthew 7:7, ask and it will be given, seek you will find it. During the day of Pentecost, disciples all gathered together, praising, praying, waiting and seeking the Lord eagerly in one accord. And they are all blessed with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Now also, when we seek Him, we will also receive the best gift of our life, the anointing of the Holy Spirit. This Tamil song, Andava Prasannamai, perfectly picture this.
Oh,
We thank the Cathedral House Group for that beautiful renditions. And now over to the Bannergatta Begur House Group. And over to Sheba Rajiv, the convener.
The third Bible reading is taken from the book of Acts the Apostles, chapter 14, verses 9 to 13. Acts chapter 14, beginning to read from verse 9. He listened to Paul speaking, and Paul, looking intently at him and seeing that he had faith to be made well, said in a loud voice, "Stand upright on your feet." And he sprang up and began walking. And when the crowd saw what Paul has done, they lifted up their voices, saying in Lycaonian, "The gods have come down to us in the likeness of men." Barnabas they called Zeus, and Paul Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. And the priest of the Zeus, whose temple was at the entrance to the city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates and wanted to offer sacrifice with the crowds. This is the reading.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A warm Pentecost Sunday to all. Today, we celebrate the Holy Spirit's fiery descent upon the disciples, igniting them with purpose and power to spread the gospel's flame. Our Bannergatta Begur House Group is thrilled to share two songs that capture Pentecost essence, the Spirit's mighty presence and our call to illuminate the world with our own light.
Our first song, Abhisheka Thode, Adhikara Thode. This beautiful melody, a blend of Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu and Kannada, celebrates the Holy Spirit's descent and the transformative power it brings. This song opens with a stirring call, "Let a new generation rise, empowered by the anointing." It envisions a future where the Holy Spirit ignites a generation ready to face challenges and usher in hope. The lyrics paint a picture of transformation. Kings will fall, nations will be captured, signifying the dismantling of oppressive systems and the establishment of God's reign. But the heart of the song lies in its powerful chorus, "A new generation will arise with anointing." This is a call for to action for each of us, empowered by the Holy Spirit, to become agents of change, capable of transforming ourselves and the world around us. Let this song's message of hope and transformation resonate within you. May we be the generation that rises with the Holy Spirit's power, ready to make a difference.
Yeah. The second song explodes with a great and mighty spirit of the Lord, a testament to the victory he brings. We then plead, shine, Jesus, shine, a heartfelt cry for God's light fueled by the Spirit, to bathe the land in grace and mercy. Woven into the melody is a beautiful prayer seeking God to search and cleanse us, filling us with his radiance to become vessel of his light. Finally, the beloved hymn, This Little Light of Mine, reminds us that within each of us burns a flame fueled by the Holy Spirit, waiting to be shared with the world.
Let us raise our voices together, reflecting on the transformative power of the Spirit within us. The Holy Spirit will break down barriers, liberate down the trodden, and bring freedom. As we sing, let each of us burn a flame fueled by the Holy Spirit, and let us recommit to letting our own light blaze brightly for Christ.
To the Banargata Begur House Group. Next, I call upon the HL Domlur House Group to come and give in their presentation. The HL Domlur House Group, the convener is Mr. David Stanley. So over to the HL Domlur House Group.
Today's fourth Bible reading on this Pentecostal Sunday is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, verses 14 and 15. Acts chapter 14, beginning to read from verse 14. But when the apostles Barnabas and Paul heard it, they tore their garments and rushed out in the crowd, crying out, "Men, why are you doing these things? We also are men of like nature with you, and we bring you good news that you should turn from these vain things to a living God who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and all that is in them." Here ends the Bible reading. Thanks be to God.
Pentecost is celebrated on the 50th day after Easter. What does Pentecost mean? The Holy Spirit is with us and available to us. We, the HAL Domlur House Group, will be singing two songs on this Pentecostal Sunday. The first one is "Come Holy Spirit," and the second is a familiar Sunday school song all over the world. The red color that you see us wearing is to signify the Holy Spirit, which descended on the disciples as tongues of fire on that special day.
Deep down in my heart, yes.
Thank you, HF Domnur House Group. Now we have a dance choreography by Ms. Namita Masikar on the theme Pentecost.
Well, good evening, everyone. Are you ready to praise the Lord? Let's stand up together and sing.
I am a new creation, no more in condemnation. Here in the grace of God I stand. My heart is overflowing, my love just keeps on growing. Here in the grace of God I stand. And I will praise you, Lord, yes, I will.
Sing now, I am.
Namita, for that beautiful presentation. I now call upon the next house group, the Banaswadi Kalyan Nagar House Group, and its convener is Lieutenant Colonel George Matthew, and they will be singing two songs, O Holy Spirit Come, Gracious Spirit Dwell With Me.
Today's Old Testament reading has been taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, verses 1 to 8. Isaiah chapter 6, beginning to read from verse 1. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high up and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim. Each had six wings, with two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. And one called to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the foundations of the thresholds shook at the voice of him who called.
and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away and your sin atoned for. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send and who will go for us? Then I said, here am I, send me. Here ends the Old Testament reading. Good evening, everyone. Today, as we continue the Pentecost Sunday service, the Banaswadi Kalyanagar House Group will present to you two songs, Gracious Spirit, Dwell With Me, and Holy Spirit, Come.
Thank you, the Banaswadi Kalyanagar House Group, for your presentation. I now call upon the Alsur Indranagar House Group, and the Alsur Indranagar House Group, the conveners are Mrs. Florence Michael and Mr. Newton Michael. So over to the Alsur Indranagar House Group.
Hear the word of God as it is recorded in the book of Titus, Chapter 3, verses 1 to 7. Titus, chapter 3, beginning to read at verse 1.
remind them to be submissive to rulers and authorities, to be obedient, to be ready for every good work, to speak evil of no one, to avoid quarreling, to be gentle, and to show perfect courtesy toward all people. For we ourselves were once foolish, disobedient, led astray, slaves to various passions and pleasures, passing our days in malice and envy, hated by others and hating one another. But when the goodness and loving kindness of God, our Savior, appeared, He saved us, not because of works done by us in righteousness, but according to His own mercy, by the washing of regeneration and renewal of the Holy Spirit, whom He poured out on us richly through Jesus Christ, our Savior, so that, being justified by His grace, we might become heirs according to the hope of eternal life. This is the word of God. The Indranagar and Alsur house group will present two numbers entitled Here I Am to Worship, and the second one is Are You Washed in the Blood?
Oh,
Thank you. I just wanted to let you know we were accompanied by Angel, Mr. Mandi and Kadirvan. Thank you.
Thank you, Al-Surindranagar House Group. The next house group is the Mission Compound Shantinagar Wilson Garden House Group. So this house group, the convener is Mr. Ajit Samuel. So over to the Mission Compound Shantinagar Wilson Garden House Group.
Request you to stand up for the gospel reading. The gospel reading is taken from the book of Mark, the gospel according to Mark, chapter 1, verses 1 to 11. Mark chapter 1, 1 to 11. The beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in Isaiah the prophet. Behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare, the way of the Lord makes his paths straight. John appeared baptizing in the wilderness and proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And all the country of Judea and all Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and wore a leather belt around his waist and ate locusts and wild honey. And he preached saying, after me comes he who is mightier than I, the strap of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And when he came up out of the water, immediately he saw the heavens being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, you are my beloved Son, with you I am well pleased. Here ends the gospel reading. Praise be to God.
Good evening to our padres, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the MSW House Group Fellowship. Our first song is a famous American Negro spiritual, which dates back to before the American Civil War. As you listen to the song, you will notice that it's a powerful combination of spirit and prayer that's indicated in the lyrics of the chorus. So without further ado, please join us as MSW House Group presents Every Time I Feel the Spirit.
Every time I
check.
And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit was giving them utterance. Well, we will be moving into another song, which is a regional song and a very popular song, which is Atma Swarupane. And if you're inspired and you want to join us, please join us. We will be singing it in Kannada as well as Tamil. So let's go ahead and enjoy this regional song and let's praise God at this moment.
Sincere thanks to MSW House Group for their excellent presentation. Praise be to God. It's a joy and blessing to celebrate Pentecost Sunday in this manner through our house groups. This has been a very special evening to each one of us. To watch the talents, the potentials of our members in each house group. Sincere thanks to the overall convener, Mrs. Anjana Samuel, for her leadership and her coordination. We're also grateful to each house group convener for their excellent leadership and also their painstaking efforts to see to that their house group presents a very special presentation for the glory of God. Heartfelt thanks and sincere appreciation to each member of the house group for your impacting and impressive presentation. May God bless each one of you. May God glorify Himself through you, and may God reward your faith and faith actions. Shall we look to God in prayer? Speak, Lord, your servants are hearing. Amen. As we celebrate Pentecost Sunday, on behalf of the members of the Pastorate Committee and the members of the clergy team, I take this opportunity to wish each one of you a happy Pentecost Sunday. The day of Pentecost is very significant because on this day, God fulfilled His promise to pour out His Spirit on all people. My beloveds in Christ, we know the fact from Scripture that we are creatures and God is our Creator. He has created us in His own likeness, in His own image, so that He would fellowship with us all time. He wants us to be part of Him. He wants us to be His co-workers. And God always longs for our fellowship. And that's the reason why He has outpoured His Spirit on each one of us, so that He would abide with us at all times, in all situations, in all circumstances. He wants to abide with us. He wants to energize us, empower us, enrich us. He wants to enlighten us so that each one of us would be a channel of blessing. He wants us to be His instruments of grace wherever He has placed us. He wants us to be a beacon of light wherever He has called us to witness to Him. It's very important that we understand the gift that God has given us, the Holy Spirit. My beloveds in Christ, the Holy Spirit is an indwelling God. He makes each one of us a living temple. God is now not residing in tents or in stone structure, in a temple. He is residing in you and me, you and me. God wants to be always in us and work through us. The Holy Spirit is an empowering, strengthening God. A God wants to strengthen each one of us so that in all eventualities, in all circumstances, whatever may be the challenges, we would be more than conquerors. He wants us to overcome everything, starting from our own weaknesses. He wants us to help us to overcome not only weaknesses, even temptations, or whatever evil that comes on our way. He wants each one of us to be more than conquerors, to show who God is and what He's doing in and through us, and show to people that He's a God who has not abandoned us. He's a God who is living in us, strengthening, empowering us all times. My beloveds in Christ, the Holy Spirit is a sanctifying God. He makes us holy through sacraments. Through baptism, He has made each one of us a child of God. A child of God. We are heirs of His kingdom, heirs of heaven. Through confirmation, He has made each one of us defenders of faith. Defenders of faith. And through the sacrament of Holy Eucharist. He is nourishing each one of us, spiritually strengthening each one of us through the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we would represent Him everywhere and continue the good works that Christ has initiated during His ministry on earth. We have so many types of celebrations. We worship God on various occasions. We offer prayers. And through all this, the Holy Spirit wants each one of us to build us into a strong community, so that through our cultural expressions, we try to not only show the bond of friendship and fellowship among us, He wants us to witness to His presence through our righteous living, to have a right relationship with God and right relationship with everyone. My beloveds in Christ, our God is not only God who indwells, who strengthens us, who sanctifies us. The Holy Spirit is a teaching and guiding God. He has been blessed to each one of us to be our counselor, to counsel us at all times, to give us ideas, to give us direction, guidance at all times. He wants us to remember the teachings of Christ. He helps us to interpret, understand, grasp. The Holy Spirit, when He is with us, He would help us to understand. Each one of us have gone through this exercise when we were studying. When we don't understand, we pray, and sometimes we sleep over, and when we get up and when we read, suddenly we begin to grasp. It's mainly because the Spirit of God helps us to understand. He helps us to develop our knowledge. He gives us wisdom to apply knowledge in a given context. He guides us by helping us to discern everything. It's not just important to just be Christ witnesses. It's very important that we discern the reality around us, make judgment and understand what role should we play and what are our expectations in a given situation. And He helps us to have a vision, to develop a vision and a mission for His glory. Holy Spirit is not only teaching and guiding God, He is listening and talking God. He listens to our prayers. If He is indwelling in us, St. Paul says that when you're so tired, when you're going through difficult times, you groan, and even in your groaning, the Holy Spirit communes with God, and He talks to God on your behalf, on your behalf. And this is what He does. He enables us to receive God's blessings in all situations, in all situations. The Holy Spirit is a giver of gifts. He gives gifts, He gives fruits, He gives us charisma to enrich us. And when we look at Scripture, He gifts us in different forms, through prophecy, through teaching, through administration, through acts of charity, healing, and speaking in tongues. And He resides in different types of people, like apostles, prophets, teachers, healers, not only these people, in every child of God. No one is overlooked. No one is neglected. He gives gifts to everyone. And Paul, in his letter to the Galatians, lists the fruits of the Spirit. He says, what the Spirit brings is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And he continues, he says, since the Spirit is our life, let us be directed by the Spirit. A life is Spirit, and we need to allow Him to direct us. And God has given us this gift not to just use for ourselves, for our own enrichment. He has given us these gifts that we may serve people, fulfill His plan and purpose in others' life. He has given us these gifts for the benefit of others, for the common good, for the common good, so that using these gifts, we would build the body of Christ, body of Christ. This is what He expects. We are so glad that each one of you are part of house group. If you're not part of a house group, we request you, we urge you to become part of house group, because you should understand the significance of house group fellowship. When you read Acts chapter 1, Jesus tells His followers, He says, "Do not leave Jerusalem. Wait for the promise of the Holy Spirit." And scholars say that when He ascended to heaven, there were nearly 500 people. Paul also mentions this in his epistle. But later, when we come to chapter 2 of Acts of Apostles, when the Holy Spirit came, there were only 120 people. What happened to the 380 people? They may be very busy. They may be having their own business, errands to do, or they may be tired or engaged in something or the other. But whatever the reason is, they missed the promise of the Holy Spirit. They were not anointed on that day. There was no outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon them. My beloveds in Christ, if you want to receive the Holy Spirit, the Word of God says that the disciples were gathered in one place, in one region. They were together in unity, and they were connected to one another. They were willing to involve in one another's life. And when they were able to do that, the Spirit of God came upon them. And that's how the church was born. My beloveds in Christ, it's very important that we are connected to one another. We gather as many times as possible in the region where we are. And it is very important that we live in unity so that God may pour out His Spirit on us, so that we would enjoy these gifts, these fruits, these charismas, and lead a rich life. May God bless each one of us, and may God bestow upon us grace upon grace through His Holy Spirit and glorify Himself. Shall we look to God in prayer? Gracious God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank You for gathering us in this manner on this special occasion. Lord, as we are interacting with You through Your word, and as we are witnessing various programs, Lord, we pray that through all these means, You would recreate each one of us with the power of the Holy Spirit. Help each one of us to be empowered so that we would proclaim Your word, witness to Your Son, our Savior Christ Jesus, in love and compassion. Bless us, be with us, and use us mightily in Your mission. For we ask these blessings in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. In response to the message from the Word of God, let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. Shall we all stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God, the Father Almighty.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the only begotten Son, the Son of God, born of the Holy Spirit.
Please be seated.
I call upon the next house group, the Cooktown Sevanagar house group, to give him their presentation. I invite the convener, Mrs. Melanie Moses, and the Cooktown Sevanagar house group.
The Bible reading is taken from Acts chapter 14, verses 17 and 18. Acts chapter 14, verses 17 and 18. Yet he did not leave himself without witness, for he did good by giving you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons, satisfying your hearts with food and gladness. Even with these words, they scarcely restrained the people from offering sacrifice to them. Here ends the Bible reading.
Good evening. Today we commemorate the descent of the Holy Spirit on the followers of Jesus Christ so many centuries ago. We echo the praises of people over the ages with a historic hymn called Come, O Holy Spirit, Come. This was sung in the 9th century in Latin called Veni Creator Spiritus. The author is Rabanus Maurus, an archbishop of the 7th century. This will be followed by a contemporary song called Baptized in Water, which is written by Canon Michael Soward, an Anglican priest in London in 1981. Through these meaningful lyrics, we are called to let God's light shine through us. Join us as we invite the Holy Spirit into our lives anew.
Spirit.
Thank you. We were accompanied by Ryan Prabhukumar on the piano. With sincere gratitude to God for all His manifold blessings that He has bestowed upon us through His Spirit, let us offer our thank offering as we sing hymn number 342. 342, come, let us all unite to sing.
As we remain standing, let us pray for the offertory collected. Let us pray. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Our next house group is the Koramangala house group. I invite Mrs. Anita Joel, who's the convener, and also Sujita Raj, the co-convener. So I invite the Koramangala house group for their presentation.
Today's reading is taken from the book, The Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, verse 19 to 21. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, verse 19 to 21. But Jews came from Antioch and Iconium, and having persuaded the crowds, they stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing that he was dead. But when the disciples gathered about him, he rose up and entered the city, and on the next day he went on with Barnabas to Derbe. When they heard preached the gospel to that city and had made many disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. Here ends the reading.
Good evening to each and every one of you. We, the Koramangala House Group, are going to render two songs. The first song is going to be sung by the children of the Koramangala House Group, which is a medley of two songs. This Is Your House by Don Moen and Praise by Elevation Worship. So please sit back and enjoy. Is a Tamil song, Sarva Logadiba Namaskaram. This song talks about the power and might of our God who created the heavens and our beautiful earth when the Holy Spirit was floating here. Let us praise and glorify His name as we welcome the triune God into our lives.
Namaskaram, Tare Tadaluyirvan Sagalamu
Thank you, Koramangala House Group, for your presentation. I would like to request everyone to kindly stay on. It's just a few more house groups. If we can encourage the rest of our fellow house group members, I think it will be a big encouragement for them. So I next welcome the McIver House Group. I request the convener, Mr. Samuel Ponaya, to go with their presentation. The McIver House Group.
The seventh reading for today is taken from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 14, verses 1 to 5. I say again, 1 Corinthians 14, beginning to read at verse 1. Prophecy and tongues. Pursue love and earnestly desire the spiritual gifts, especially that you may prophesy. For one who speaks in a tongue speaks not to men but to God. For no one understands him, but he utters mysteries in the spirit. On the other hand, the one who prophesies speaks to people for their upbuilding and encouragement and consolation. The one who speaks in a tongue builds up himself, but the one who prophesies builds up the church. Now I want you all to speak in tongues, but more to prophecy. The one who prophesies is greater than the one who speaks in tongues, unless someone interprets, so that the church may be built up. This is the word of God.
Dear St. Mark's Cathedral family, greetings to you on behalf of our Micawber Town House Group, the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Lord. We are delighted to participate in today's celebration of the Holy Spirit Sunday.
Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on us. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on us.
Chapter 5, 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, kindness, meekness, faithfulness, gentleness, temperance, and long sufferings.
Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in us.
O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile. O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile. O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile. O Holy Spirit, O Holy Spirit, heal and reconcile.
St. Mark's Cathedral family. Amen.
Sure. Shalom. Thank you very much, McIver House Group. I now call upon the R.T. Nagar House Group and the convener is Mr. Eugene Moses. So over to the R.T. Nagar House Group.
Today's 8th Bible reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verses 6 to 12. 1 Corinthians 14, beginning to read from verse 6. Now brothers, if I come to you speaking in tongues, how will I benefit you unless I bring you some revelation or knowledge or prophecy or teaching? If even lifeless instruments, such as the flute or the harp, do not give distinct notes, how will anyone know what is played? And if the bugle gives an indistinct sound, who will get ready for battle? So with yourself, if with your tongue you utter speech that is not intelligible, how will anyone know what is said? For you will be speaking into the air. There are doubtless many different languages in the world, and none is without meaning. But if I do not know the meaning of the language, I will be a foreigner to the speaker, and the speaker a foreigner to me. So with yourselves, since you are eager for manifestations of the Spirit, strive to excel in building up the church. Here ends the Bible reading.
Good evening, everyone. As we all know, today is Pentecost Sunday. This day is celebrated as the 50 days after Easter. And this is the day where we as Christians remember the gift of the Holy Spirit. We, the R.T. Nagar House Group, on this special day will be singing two songs, Shine Jesus Shine and Waymaker.
Truth, you now bring us shine.
Thank you, Artinagar House Group, especially the little ones. Thank you so much.
Let us join praying together the collect. The Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, protecting me, the Father over me, the Savior within me, the Spirit about me, the Holy Three defending me. As evening comes, bless our homes, watch over us as shadows fall. Hear our cry when we call. Sacred Three, keep us in your grace. Amen to thee, Holy Three. Amen.
I now call upon the Fraser Town House Group, and the convener is Mr. Sam Mohan. So over to the Fraser Town House Group.
The ninth reading is taken from the first letter, St. Paul's Corinthians, chapter 14, verses 13 to 18. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, beginning to read at 13. Therefore, one who speaks in a tongue should pray for the power to interpret. For all I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my mind is unfruitful. What am I to do? I will pray with my spirit, but I will pray with my mind also. I will sing praise with my spirit, but I will sing with my mind also. Otherwise, if you give thanks with your spirit, how can I, anyone in the position of the outsider say amen? To your thanksgiving when he does not know what are you doing, saying, for you may be giving thanks well enough, but the other person is not being built up. I thank God that I speak in tongues more than all of you. This is the word of the Lord.
Good evening, dear friends, and wish you all a happy Pentecost Day. We, the members of Fraser Town House Group, are happy to sing for you two songs to glorify God. The first one is a song of prayer, inviting the Holy Spirit to breathe on us, fill us with life anew, and make our hearts pure. The second is Amazing Grace, written by John Newton, who was a slave trader, and expresses the grace of God who brought him out of many dangers, toils, and snares. We would read Acts 4, 8 to 13 to show the power of the Holy Spirit. Peter showed by his boldness in declaring salvation is only in Jesus Christ our Lord. No, it's already started playing, it's okay. Yeah.
Love and grace, you can all join in it. Hymn number 26 in the books.
God bless you all.
Shall we join together in the intercessory prayer? Your response will be, Lord, have mercy. Father, you enfold us with wings of love, as a bird protects her young. In our sin, we have spurned your love. Lord, have mercy. Response, Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you gather us around you that we may learn your ways to be a community for others. In sin, we have strayed from your presence. Christ, have mercy. Response, Christ, have mercy. Holy Spirit, you feed us with the seed of your holy word. In sin, we have chosen the chaff. Spirit, give us discernment. Response, Holy Spirit, help us to choose rightly. Amen.
I thank the Fraser Town House Group for their presentation. And now, the last but not the least, they've been waiting patiently, is the Electronic City Sajapur House Group. And I invite Mr. Sam David, the convener, and also Mrs. Santana Stephen, the co-convener.
Brothers, do not be children in your thinking. Be infants in evil, but in your thinking be mature. In the law it is written, by people of strange tongues and by lips of foreigners will I speak to this people, and even then they will not listen to me, says the Lord. Thus tongues are a sign not for believers, but for unbelievers, while prophecy is a sign not for unbelievers, but for believers. If, therefore, the whole church comes together and all speak in tongues, and outsiders or unbelievers enter, will they not say that you are out of your minds? But if all prophecy and an unbeliever prophesy and an unbeliever or outsider enters, he is convicted by all. He is called to account by all. The secrets of his heart are disclosed, and so, falling on his face, he will worship God and declare that God is really among you. Here ends the reading. Praise be to God.
Pentecostal Sunday, or Pentecost, celebrates the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles.
making the birth of the Christian church. Observed 7 weeks after Easter, it emphasized spiritual renewal and divine empowerment. As we celebrate the Pentecostal Sunday, we, the Electronic City and Sajapur House Group, are going to present two songs, one English song, Holy, 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 and the second number is a Tamil number, Aviyanavari. Please to join us as we sing.
Lord God Almighty,
I would like to thank the Electronic City Sajapur House Group. At this time, I would like to take the opportunity to thank each and every one of us present here. Thank you for the encouragement, support, and those of us who are not members of the house group, please feel free to meet with us and fellowship at the resource center. And if you have a house group close to your area, then please do join. It has been a great pleasure and a great feeling to bond with so many house groups, so many conveners and so many members. It's been a great experience for me personally. I would like to sincerely thank our presbyter, Reverend Dr. Vincent Vinod Kumar, for his constant support and encouragement, and for journeying. We have been journeying together for 6 years now. And thank you, Aya, for everything. And also to the assistant presbyter, Mr. Reverend Sam Jabadurai. I also would like to thank our clergy, Reverend Dr. Thomas Nainan. He's the leader for the Whitefield House Group. So anybody here represents Whitefield, you could contact him. Reverend Clement Rajkumar, always there, a constant help and support. And Reverend Sujana Pramanik, thank you so much for all your support and encouragement. I would like to thank my PC members and also the office bearers, especially the treasurer, for the support. I would like to thank all the house group conveners, all the house group participating members, and all the musicians, especially Dennis, our organist today. Thank you so much, Dennis. And also Hansel, our young pianist who has been helping many house groups today. Thank you so much. I would like to thank the staff, especially our AO, and Muthu for helping us with all the sound and support, David with the coffee, and also all our organizing team who you will meet at the parish hall. And thank you so much. And this link will be sent, and you can have a look at the program. It is recorded and it will be posted. Thank you so much, Desi Pearl, for your support. And I would also like to thank the caterers who have helped us today. And thank you for everything. Thank you very much for staying back. And good night, and over to our presbyter.
Shall we all bow our heads in prayer? Almighty God, who has given us a grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplications to you, and thus promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill us now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of your servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. Shall we all join together, say the Lord's Prayer? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And save us from all time, the trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Unto God's almighty hands, let us commit ourselves, very especially the entire family of St. Mark's. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst us and remain with us always. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of